Hey, welcome back. If you are new to chickens or you've got kids, there are 6 bird traits that you really must know about before selecting a breed. So today we're going to talk about those. Before we talk about these bird traits, I want to ask you to subscribe to the channel because we got a lot of great information for you here on homesteading and our experience doing it. We've also got a few chores to take care of before we do anything this morning. The girls are helping me out. They usually do. The little one is doing a good job, aren't you? All right, good job. Then we're going to do what? Feed the kitties?
Yeah.
Yeah, feed the doggies? Here we go. Up here. Yay. Here we go. Here, do that one over there too. Can you do that one over there? You see it? You know where it is? Good job. Down there on the floor, on the ground. You see it? You don't know where it is? It's right there. See it? The kitty bowl. There we go. Just a little bit. Let me see. All right, trait number one is bird size. So different breeds are different sizes. Like, say, a Rhode Island Red is usually 7 pounds on a hen. And this is going to directly correlate to your building of your coop, because the nesting boxes need to be the proper size for the breed that you have or the breeds that you have. So if you're looking at a certain chicken, you need to figure out how big your coop needs to be and how big your nesting boxes need to be. That's really important. Trait number two is roosting height. Now, different birds will roost at different heights. So when you're building your coop, you need to know how high your bird likes to roost. The birds that we're going to choose, and I'm going to talk about it at the end of the video, are similar in their roosting height. So we can build our bars in a certain range, and we know that the birds are going to be comfortable sitting in that position, and they're not too low or not too high. So figure the roosting height when you're thinking about your chicken breeds. So trait number three is important to me because I have kids, and that's thinking about the temperament of your birds. Now, some birds are aggressive, some are hyper, some are, you know, they like to run around a lot like crazy. Some are docile, some like to have you hold them, and the breeds that I'm going to pick are ones that kids can be around really easily and that are easy to take care of. Those chicken breeds are very docile in their nature, so they'll let you pick them up, they'll let you hold them, pet them, whatever, and they're not going to, you know, go crazy running away. Now, I know that my neighbor has a lot of different chicken breeds, and she raised them all from baby chicks, like we will, and she talked to them all the time, and she held them all the time when they were chicks, and even her more hyper breeds are fairly docile now because of that work that she put in at the beginning. So that's always something to think about as well. But for us, with the kids, with the little one, she's only 2.5, we are going to pick birds that have a docile temperament. Now, a big thing for beginners is handling what's called a broody bird. A broody bird is a bird that wants to sit on her eggs to hatch them. So in my opinion, if you're a beginner or a novice, or you're just getting back into it like me, then you need to pick a bird that's called a non-setter. So she doesn't want to hatch her eggs out into chicks. She doesn't care about it. So there's a lot of different bird breeds, and those two breeds that we're going to choose, they're both non-setters and not broody at all. Point number five is if you want a dual-purpose bird, which is a bird essentially that tastes great if you want to eat them, or they lay a lot of eggs and they're great producers. So keep that in mind when you want a bird. For us, we just want our layers, to be pets, and to produce a good amount of manure for our garden. That's real important for us as well. Here is our nesting box in our coop. It's full of tools right now, but this gives me an opportunity to talk to you about the last trait, trait number six, and that is how good of an egg producer your chickens are. So if you're mainly getting your laying chickens for obviously laying eggs, then you want to research the best laying chickens. Not all the chickens that lay these cool colored eggs like blue eggs or green eggs, greenish tinted eggs, or even some brown eggs are good layers. But the breeds that we're going to talk about, that we're going to choose, they are all good layers, and that means that they lay between 200 to 300 eggs per year. Some of those breeds can lay a little bit more, some a little bit less, but in that range there, 200 to 280 eggs per year is a lot of eggs. So if you've got 8 birds and they're all producing pretty well, you're going to be selling a ton of eggs, or you're going to be eating a lot of eggs. So I had some memory from when I was a kid, from when we had chickens and the breeds that we had. My dad did his due diligence when picking these chickens out, because he had the same situation that we have. He wanted great layers. He wanted good docile birds for us kids as we were running around. And I need to do the same thing for my kids. So there are two websites. I'm going to link them below, and I'm going to show one right here that show you the breeds and those characteristics of those breeds that I was talking about. Now, each site is a little bit different, so I had to cross-reference between the two, but those are the best two that I found. Now let's talk about the breeds that I chose and the reason that I chose them. I'm going to talk about 5 different breeds, and first I'm going to talk about 3 that we didn't choose and then the 2 that we did. The breeds are not that similar, but they're very popular, and so you need to know what the characteristics are, or the traits are, of these specific breeds to see if they're good for you. Now it's really cool because my neighbor has all of these breeds and a couple more, but the first one I want to talk about is the Buff Orpington. The Buff Orpington is a big bird. It's about 8 pounds. The hens are about 8 pounds. So all the poundage I'm going to talk about are for the hens, because we don't really want roosters. But if you do, the roosters are obviously a little bigger. So Buff Orpingtons are 8-pound birds normally, and the one trait I don't like about them is that they're extremely broody. They get broody a lot. So if you are a novice or a beginner, I probably wouldn't recommend those, because you're going to need to deal with that broodiness of that hen. Also, Buff Orpingtons are very hot and cold tolerant, and that's important. Actually, all the birds that we are talking about are hot and cold tolerant. That's great for our area here in East Texas, because it does get down into the 20s, although not a lot of days down in the 20s, but it's super hot in the summertime. You know, last summer I think we had hundreds for a month straight. So you're going to need to think about that characteristic as well when you're looking for a bird. And I guess you can apply that to being a 7th point from earlier in the video, and whether or not the bird can handle your climate in your area. So Buff Orpingtons also are great egg layers, between 200 and 280 eggs a year. So that makes them a great bird to have if you want good egg production. They are also roosting at a height of 2 to 4 feet. So keep that in mind when you're thinking about that bird. Two more things about the Buff Orpington. One is, if you're looking for a bantam breed, which is a smaller breed of the same chicken, they do produce less. Some bantam breeds for other breeds, some bantams for other breeds, produce the same in terms of egg laying, but the bantams for the Buff Orpingtons produce less. Buffs are also a good dual purpose bird because they're a good tasting chicken. Let's talk about leghorns. Everybody knows the white leghorn bird. A lot of people love them because they are great layers. They lay between 220 and 300 eggs per year, so that's really great production. They're a little bit smaller bird, around 4.5 to 5 pounds, and they're not broody at all, which is really cool. White leghorns are very heat tolerant. They don't mind the cold as well, so they're good for here in Texas, but they're very, very active birds, so you need a fairly good size run to have some leghorns. Next up on the list are red sexlinks or golden comets. There's another name for them, but usually in this area of Texas they're called red sexlinks. I think other parts of the South maybe they're called golden comets, but or comets. But these birds are good layers. They lay between 200 and 280 eggs a year, so that's really good. Unfortunately, they're not very friendly. Now, my neighbor has some that are okay. They're more of a hyperactive bird and they run away a lot. But since I have kids, we're not going to have any of the golden comets or red sexlinks in our flock. So the golden comets or red sexlinks are also a good dual purpose bird, and they're not broody at all, which is really nice. So they're not friendly, but they're not broody, which is kind of weird, but that's the way it is with them. They are very hot and cold tolerant, and they also have a roost height of 2 to 4 feet. All right, those last two breeds, the two breeds that we're gonna get, the two breeds that I had growing up, and we're gonna talk about these breeds as I check out our garden here. Ooh, I need to do some serious work in here. I've got some weeds going on like crazy. Who knew weeds could grow like this so crazy in the wintertime, but it's Texas, right? So I gotta get this set for, oh man, I got asparagus to prune, I got raspberries to prune, yikes. All right, those two breeds are both very hot and cold tolerant. They lay a ton of eggs per year, which is 200 to 280 eggs of the year. They both are not broody. They both are very friendly. They both roost at the same height, 2 to 4 feet. The only difference between these two breeds, which are Barred Rocks or Plymouth Rocks, depending on what you want to call them, that I think that's a regional deal, and Rhode Island Reds. Rhode Island Reds are a little bit smaller bird. They are about 6 to 6.5 pounds, and the Barred Rocks are 7 pounds, and some can get a little bit bigger, maybe 7.5 pounds. Those are the two very cool breeds, the special breeds that we're gonna get, the most popular breeds, because I want them to be friendly around our kids. I want them to lay a lot of eggs. I want them to not be broody. And these are the two perfect breeds for us. So if all of those characteristics for those two birds are something that you're looking for, get those two. And in a flock of only about 8 is what we're gonna start with. Those two birds are the ones for us. So if those are the types of characteristics you're looking for in your chickens, like we are, then pick those two, Rhode Island Reds and Barred Rocks. You will be very happy with both of those as we were growing up. Also, I want to send you over to check out our video on a chicken brooder. There are 5 things in a chicken brooder that you need to have in order to have a successful raising of your little chicks. So go check that video out and be sure to stay tuned for our coop build videos coming up, our chicken run video and our coop build.